Hey everyone, let's talk about how to convert units of measurement in Microsoft Excel. This is going to be done through a built-in Microsoft Excel function called the convert function. The convert function will take in some unit of measurement, like feet for example, and convert that to any equivalent unit of measurement that we wish, such as meters, yards, angstroms, etc. Alright, so let's talk about how to use the convert function. Firstly, let's do the example we just talked about. We have the following table of measurements in feet, and we want to convert it to meters. In the second column, we have meters, which is what we want to convert to. So, we will call our convert function by typing equals convert and hitting tab, and this will show us the arguments that our function wants. Firstly, the number argument is the value that is to be converted, so that is our feet cell to the left here. Then we will add a comma, and our second argument is the from unit. Meaning, from which unit are we going to be converting? And, as you can see, as soon as Excel recognizes we are here, it'll show us all the beginning unit conversions that we can choose from. So, moving through this list here, you can see all the options that we have. Since we have feet, we are just going to select that, and you can see that Excel will populate our from unit with FT for feet. Then again, we have one more argument to enter, which is the to unit. This is what we want our feet to be converted into, which, as we said earlier, is going to be meters. Therefore, let's go down the list here and find meter and select that. Double-clicking meter and closing off our brackets, you can see that we have converted 43 feet to meters easily in Microsoft Excel. To complete this, for the remainder of our values in this column, we can select the cell that we were just working with, go to the bottom right corner, and double-click it. And this will populate all the possible values below with the same formula. And there we go, we just converted our whole table to meters easily. This was something I never knew you could easily do in Microsoft Excel, and it made my life much easier once I figured it out. So, let's go through another example together, and I'll give you a more challenging example at the end to make sure that you fully understand how to use the convert function. Let's say that you are a baker, and you are given a recipe completely in cups. However, you only have a tablespoon, so let's convert them to that. To do this, let's just do as we did before, type equals convert to call the convert function. Hit tab, or manually enter the left parentheses. Click the cell value that we want to convert, and then comma, go through our list and find cup. Double click it, then add another comma, and we will repeat the process and find tablespoons, which is TBS. Finish off our function with the right parentheses, and there we go. Then, let's click this cell, double-click it on the bottom right corner to populate all the cells below it with the same equation, and there we go. We just converted our whole recipe to tablespoons. Now let's do one more example. Let's try an example that's a bit more challenging to make sure that you fully understand how to use this function. Let's say that you are given 1 kilogram per meter squared, and we are asked to convert it to pounds of mass per foot squared in a single cell conversion, meaning we are asked to do all the relevant conversions within this single cell. Take a minute now and try to work out the solution on your own, and we will go through the answer together in a minute. The answer you are looking for here is 0.204. So, we can begin by converting our kilograms to pounds, just like before. And we can do that like so. However, how do we go about getting our meter units converted to pounds within the same equation? Well, I'm going to draw this one out so it's easier to understand. Here you can see our first equation, and since we do not have kilograms, I had to multiply our kilograms by 1000 to get it in terms of grams for the conversion to pounds. And then we are left with the units of pounds per meter squared. To convert the meters squared, we need to divide by our meter squared to feet squared conversion. And this gives us our desired answer of 0.2048. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how we can use the convert function in Microsoft Excel to convert various units of measurements easily. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.